Hello everyone, I'm Suparna Shree and you're watching the medical news updates. Today I am here to run you through to the most important news related to your career in medicine. So let's start with the headlines. More than 300 students cracked JEE and NEET examination through center's free coaching scheme. The free coaching scheme, that is a financial aid to the eligible students who belong to the SC/ST and the OBC category. The free coaching scheme, which is a financial aid to all the eligible students who belong to the SC/ST or the OBC category, has been availed by 2,046 students in the year 2018 and 19, out of which 300 students have been benefited by this scheme. 300 students approximately have cleared the entrance exam of medical and engineering too. In 2017-18, a total of 2,150 students had been benefited from this scheme, which is close to 5 times more than the number of students who had availed the free coaching in 2016-17. This information was shared by Ratan Lal Kataria, Minister of State for Social Justice and Empowerment in the Lok Sabha. In response to Shobha's question on the free coaching scheme instituted for the government for SC and OBC candidates, Mr. Kataria also replied that 2005 such students have cleared the National Medical Entrance Examination, NEET, and 114 have aced the Engineering Entrance Test, JEE, while 19 such students have cleared the UPSC examination. 45 students who took the government's free coaching have cleared the exam conducted by the State Public Service Commission. So far, a total of 31 institutes have been recognized by the selection committee appointed by the government to provide free coaching in competitive exam to SC and OBC students. NEET fails to ensure merit-based admission. Though there were only about 61,000 seats that has to be filled from NEET 2019, in the early years of NEET, ranks of students who got admitted to the medical college went down to 8.45 lakhs. That raises a question. If lakhs of students with much high score did not get admitted to medical colleges, but some at the bottom did, can these admissions can be merit-based? Let's look at the analysis of Times of India's report. Not only in general category, but in every category, students with low ranks have got admitted, which is in a system based on merit within each category, ought to have gone to those which have much high scores. How is this possible? In many of the private colleges where students with low scores have got admission, the annual fee ranges from rupees 17 lakh to rupees 23 lakh for regular seats. It goes up to rupees 33 lakhs per year. The cost of MBBS course in such colleges would be well beyond a crore. Once hostel fee, exam fee and various other charges are added, for a large number of students with high scores, this would be way beyond reach. This is possible because the percentile cutoff being set lower allows a ratio of 1:13 or 13 qualified students being available for each seat, helping college go down the list of qualified NEET candidates till they find ones who can afford the fees they can charge. NEET mum on subject marks, but low scorers are still getting admission in MBBS. Last year, Times of India has exposed the students who got zero and single digit or negative marks in NEET examination in 2017 still got admitted to medical colleges. Is this practice still going on? Because from this year, NEET is not going to release the individual subject marks of each and every subject. The National Testing Agency, that is the NTA, would be releasing the percentile scores only. Now let's look at the data assessed by the Times of India. There are hundreds, if not thousands, with single digit percentile scores in physics and chemistry who have got admission in MBBS. For instance, a student whose score was 1.7 percentile in physics got admission into a private medical college. This means that 98.3% of students who wrote NEET scored higher than him in physics, or that his marks fell among the bottom 1.7 scores of the 15.2 lakh students who took the test. Earlier, NEET scorecard included marks scored in each subject as well as the total marks out of 720, overall percentile and NEET rank. In 2018, colleges and state medical education administrators stop putting out roll numbers and date of birth of candidate in the list of admitted students, so that no one could check their marks. Despite this, Times of India managed to get data from 2018 admissions to show that yet again candidates with single digit, zero and negative marks were getting admission. Instead of bringing in individual subject cutoffs, the NTA has now done away with the individual subject marks altogether. Questions to the Health Ministry, MCI, NTA did not get any response beyond the MCI saying they should be addressed to the NTA. NTA officials said that the decision to not give marks was because zero and negative marks gave a poor impression, especially if such student got admission. Though there were less than 61,000 seats available in medical college in 2019, ranks of those who got admission go down all the way up to 8.45 lakhs. This was all about the medical news updates. If you want to get into these news, kindly check the description box below. And if you find this video informative, kindly like, share and subscribe. Thank you.